previously on Vampire Diaries.
Slow it down. Sipping on propane. Sipping on propane. Sipping on.
Have you had any blackouts? Instances of lost time?
Listening in the scissor,
yeah.
Sipping on some scissor, riding with Rodrigo while she's driving through the suburbs. Jeremy's goes X's,
right.
Sending him goes Texas. I bet before they left, he got to get him some ghost
meat.
Okay, let's go.
Four out of the brothers, bond. Season 4's coming on. Ashley could chop it up about what's going on. Devin is 8 from B, trying to kill OGs. Tyler, hybrid side. Caroline turns 18. Here comes season 4. Someone bolt the door. Get the diary out. It's time for them meeting now.
Woo!
No, it's best you had to drop a human blood.
Hello. Oh, Pug snores immediately. Hello, welcome to the Vampire Diaries, the Vampire Diaries podcast. I didn't even know she was asleep. She was just awake walking around. The Vampire Diaries podcast, where a guy is watching the series for the first time with a super fan who has seen every episode. I'm the titular PD. Let's just say I put the PD in Van PD, but please call me Pete, and I'm here with a snoring pug and my co-host and co-parent, Ash. Ash, hello.
Just kidding, hey.
Oh, wait, that was you the whole time. Ash, we are in no vamp-ber.
Oh, no. Yes, vamp-ber.
We're in yes, vamp. the best month of the year. We're out of all that spooky stuff, and now it's time to cozy up.
Are we ever out of the spooky stuff, though?
I'm taking a break, because I hit it hard for September and October.
As far as all the movies and stuff you were getting into?
Yeah, I watched probably too many.
You started early this season.
All of September. If you go to my Letterboxd, all of September and October, except for Blonde, which still was kind of scary in its own way.
Yeah.
Did I have anything else?
A couple and the Bonds.
A couple Bonds in there, but it will be November Bond, and yeah.
There's not enough Thanksgiving media to consume.
I agree.
People need to get on that, because there should be more movies and stuff about Thanksgiving.
I know. That's my big pitch. Mm-hmm. There should be a Hallmark style glut of Thanksgiving movies.
Yeah. Untapped market, really.
It is.
Mm-hmm.
I did hear that it's kind of because Thanksgiving is only an American thing. I guess Canadians have Canadian Thanksgiving, but it's kind of not a global holiday.
Well, I want it.
Yeah, okay. I'll start working on that.
Okay.
Ash, there's something important we need to talk about.
Okay.
This season, SNL, season 40, whatever, episode 2, host Brendan Gleeson, original air date, October 8th, 2022.
Mm-hmm.
A sketch called Blood Oath.
Mm-hmm.
Written by the treacherous Mikey Day, Claire O'Kane, Streeter Seidel.
Oh, wow.
Now, the sketch revolved around some kind of like warring factions of Vikings or something like that.
Yeah.
Or maybe some kind of Game of Thrones make them up or whatever. But anyway, it was around taking a blood oath where they sliced, well, Brendan Gleeson notably, sliced his palm like we always talk about on this podcast.
Yeah, it was exactly like you slice it across your hand way too much.
Yes.
Instead of we always say you could do just a little pinprick or something, because you only need like a drop of blood.
Which I think that's what Mikey Day's character did.
Yeah. And then the rest of them were like, oh, you just do it a little bit.
And then Brendan Gleeson, he has the liquid hose out there spraying blood all over the place.
Over everyone.
We've seen that hose used for barf in SNL sketches previously. Not sure if we've seen it with that much blood before. But, Ash, that's our whole thing that we talk about all the time.
I know. It was so satisfying to see it just get out of control. Because I'm like, yeah. Of course he was confused, because everyone always does the big hand slice.
I'm glad you find plagiarism satisfying. I wonder which one of these writers listens to our podcast. We talk about it every time they do it in the show, which they do it in the show every week, I think.
I know. If only we worked on SNL, we could have pitched the sketch ourselves.
Yeah, they kind of went deep with it and did a whole thing, so good for them. But
they went deep with it for sure.
Yes.
Deep cut.
First cut is the deepest. If one of these three con artists listens to the podcast, you got to reach out. Tell us.
Just be like, yeah.
Just admit it.
Yeah. Like, yeah. That was, I took your idea. And be like, yeah. All right, cool.
Took it and ran with it. And we'll be like, you know what?
Keep listening to our pod. Thank you.
Send, like, I'm sure they have more followers than us. So send a tweet out about how you like the podcast.
Right.
Ash. Season 4, Episode 3. The Rager. You ever been to a rager? A raging party? Keg stands?
Yeah, actually.
And headbands? Keg stands and headbands?
Yeah. I have been to my fair share of ragers.
What's your keg count?
I've never done a keg stand.
I don't know that I have either. Seems like something I would have... Actually, no. It doesn't seem like something I would have done because I would have been too busy judging the people doing it.
I don't like it, and I also have never done... Well, the a beer... What is it called? Bong? Mm-hmm. But people from New Jersey who went to our high school called it funneling. But I didn't do that either because I'm like, I don't ever want to drink something that fast. That's gross to me.
Totally.
And I'm a slow sipper.
Yes, and I, of course, have no comment on any of the previous subjects. Ash, we are now watching the show. You know, we used to be Netflix and chilling when watching these. We are now...
HBO Maxing and Relaxing?
That's great. We're not, though.
Oh, where are we on?
Peacocking and... Balling?
Oh, man. I wish it was HBO Maxing and Relaxing.
That is good.
What is it? Peacocking and... I don't know.
Peacocking.
I came up with my one good idea for the day already.
Yeah. Well, I only say this because there was a weird recap, and I don't know, was that the recap that played on Season 4, Episode 3, IRL?
I can't remember.
Or was this the Peacock special?
It did seem different than the previous recaps, but yeah, I don't know if it was Peacock putting together their own little thing or it was the real one.
It'd be weird if Peacock did that.
Yeah, why are they spending time doing that?
And how would they get that VO? Because it was the characters narrating what happened to the audience, like... Jeremy like, whoa, last week, blah, blah, blah. And Elaine's like, now, dude, doing this.
Yeah, it was weird. It was different. It wasn't just like Stefan saying his one thing.
I live in this town.
Yeah.
And I jump from this rooftop, and then I go to high school.
Yeah, it was different for sure. We'll have to see when we watch next week's if it's still that weird one.
Okay.
Maybe they just switched it like mid-season, but yeah, I don't remember... See, I don't even remember seeing recaps when I originally watched it. I guess it probably had them.
Must have.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. Cold open.
Classic.
Ty is sleeping. There's a police officer watching his door. They're in the hospital.
Right. Because they sent him to the hospital even though he was fine.
Yeah, his mom sent him to the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
The cop hears a sound and leaves his post. It's Connor Jordan. He takes out the cop, goes in Ty's room, but Ty has whooshed away. They wrestle, because I guess Ty whooshes back, and Connor Jordan injects him with something, then takes something from his teeth. He injects him with the thing and then takes it out.
Yeah, two different syringe actions going on.
Two different uses of the syringe.
You gotta know that Connor Jordan isn't trustworthy because he has two first names.
Oh, yeah.
Just saying. Sorry to you guys out there. Two first names.
I mean, all right, look. Here's the ultimate. What if there was a set of twins with two first names each?
That is an ultimate right there.
That's technically three first names because they have the same last name, probably.
I'm right, but different first names. Yeah. That's a character for you in one of your things.
Yeah.
These twins with three first names.
Yeah, get out of here. And again, like, we can apologize to people with two first names and twins, which we rail against often, but agree to disagree.
Also, we can still chill and we'd be a friend, but I'll just be like,
we just don't agree with your lifestyle.
Yeah, I just would never name my children that.
Ash, we're just kidding. Then Connor is gone. Title.
Yeah, it was a very, very short cold open.
Connor is working in his laboratory. Probably during the day. His lab, he has a Breaking Bad RV.
Mm-hmm.
There's no suspect in the church shooting.
No.
Good for him, he thinks. And he has files on Jeremy and Elena.
The Gilberts.
The Gilbert files. Dun-dun-dun-dun. Wait,
no. That's not it.
No, dun-dun-dun-dun. That's Bond. But. But what's X-Files?
I have no idea.
Something like that.
That might be like some Disney or something.
Don't fact check me.
I don't know.
Fact check me. all right. Stephen, I wrote, is working on his hog.
Oh, yeah.
AKA motorcycle. He wants Elena to have some fun, and Damon says, those who can't do, and by that he means have fun, teach. Those who can't do, teach.
Yeah, but that's the weirdest thing ever.
Mm-hmm.
I hate that people say that.
Yeah, about teachers?
Yeah.
It's more like those that can do and have done teach, because they know how to do it.
Right. Exactly. Then we teach others how to do it.
Yeah. Damon is going to eat Connor Jordan because he took Ty's werewolf venom. And I said, werewolf venom is new to me.
No, it's not.
Yeah. I never heard of werewolf venom.
Well, a werewolf bite is deadly to vampires.
Yeah, I didn't know it was because of their venom.
Oh, you thought it was just because of, like, some teeth marks?
I just thought it was because they bit him and then it happened.
Hmm. I guess I maybe hadn't thought it through, like, so specifically.
Like, what's something similar? Like, a zombie biting someone and turns them into a zombie. It's not because of their venom.
Well, but the bite, like, becomes infectious.
Mm-hmm. I've never heard of it called venom.
Yeah,
especially
okay.
Fair enough. Especially from a werewolf. I think a werewolf just ripping people up.
Uh-huh.
Zombies are like a disease.
Yeah.
And that's not even venom, though. Venom is poison. Right. Zombie is like a bacterial infection or something. If we're going to make the supernatural scientific. Whoever Elena doesn't choose between these bros was going to leave Mystic Falls.
Right, which I still think that's a stupid idea.
But now she's a vampire, so I guess that changes it. And,
yeah, because then they're like, all right, I guess you're going to leave for hundreds of years or whatever.
Yeah, well, they had that good idea of, like, swapping every 100 years or whatever. That doesn't really give Elena the authority in that.
No, they always try to take away her, like,
agency.
Yeah, her agency, like, her rights.
So Damon feels not wanted because he and Elena shared blood and then Stefan punched him.
Mm-hmm.
He feels not wanted. Matt meets Elena at their old makeout spot.
Mm-hmm.
So she can drink his blood.
Yeah, he was like, isn't this kind of weird to do this? Because they're kind of like making out, but in a different way.
Mm-hmm. He's a human blood bank. And I said, don't worry, he gets something out of it, too. A little nuck-sucking. A little neck-sucking. Nuck-sucking sounds way worse.
That
sounds
way worse.
But it doesn't mean
you
anything.
You just change the vowels.
A little neck-suck. He gets a little neck-sucking.
Yeah.
She brought him a large Band-Aid.
Yeah. Here you go.
Elena wants to be at school during her senior year. That's cool, I guess.
Yeah, she's still like, I'm a vampire, but I'm still going to do my normal life stuff that she's always been struggling to do because she's been dating vampires and it's been hard the whole time.
Mm-hmm. But look, senior year, man.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta do it.
Or you can just be like Rebecca and just like do senior year whenever.
Mm-hmm.
You can...
She's catching up on senior year. She's a super senior.
Yeah. Well, Rebecca missed, like, all her fun things.
She took a gap year.
When she was in the coffin forever.
You know that, Ash, I took a gap year?
Oh, really?
Yeah, and I worked at the Gap.
Close. You worked at Banana Republic.
Yeah, and not even on a gap year.
You took a banana year?
I took a banana year during school. That's not it. It's terrible.
Hmm.
I was like, I gotta walk over to this mall for like $35.
I know. I was always telling you not to go to work.
I know. There's a curfew because Ty got shot.
Yeah, curfew for the town.
Yep, which I'm about to talk about that in a second, but...
Okay.
Ty and his mom at the Lockwood house. Klaus is there with hybrids who look like Ty.
Mm-hmm.
They look like Ty, these two dudes.
Yeah, they're just kind of, like, far away. You can't, like, see them up close, but their, like, whole physique and coloring and everything just looks like there's, like, three Ties in the room.
Mm-hmm. And Klaus is dressed as Ryan Atwood.
Uh-huh.
And we got Tyler Lockwood and Ryan Atwood.
Oh, man.
And then Ash was like, are they Ty's stand-ins getting non-speaking extra roles?
Yeah, I was like, maybe they just got his stand-ins for this role instead of, like, hiring someone else.
Which, hopefully they got paid both their stand-in rate and a non-speaking extra role rate, because if they had to give up their stand-in rate for the non-speaking extra role rate, the non-speaking extras make a lot less.
Yeah, so that wouldn't be good.
No, hopefully they're getting that double payment.
Double dipping.
Yeah. For this imaginary thing.
For this theory I have.
Making up.
Years ago.
Ty's mom is like, what? Why are there three of my sons in here?
We have triplets I didn't know about.
Klaus can't make any more hybrids. I didn't think of that either, Ash.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because, unless I said that in a previous episode, but because Elena's a vampire now.
Yeah.
Do you think
the doppelganger.
Do you think he banked some of her blood? I mean, why am I asking you that?
He's trying to.
I think he, Pete-dictions, I think he banks some of her blood that's going to come up if he's still around in, like, season 5 or 6. He's going to be like, don't you know that I banked some of your blood?
Yeah. I stole your blood, and I've been banking it.
And it's time to make a withdrawal.
Withdrawal.
A withdrawal.
Oh my gosh.
That's not so much about how he talks, that's just kind of, it's hard to say the word. Withdrawal. Stefan and Elena are back in Alark's classroom for the first time, and they're sad, and it's a moment, but
yeah.
Then Rebecca comes in and messes with my moment that I'm trying to have.
I know, that's so annoying.
She's throwing an anti-curfew party, which Kevin Williamson did in Scream 1. That's why they're all over at Randy's house.
Mm-hmm.
And spoilers for Scream 5 Cream. Whatever, we said 5 Cream?
Yeah, 5 Cream.
They're back
mm-hmm.
at Randy's house. Spoilers, sorry.
But not for curfew that time.
I forget. We need to watch that again.
That was good. And we were just saying not to watch scary movies. But
I know. I even, like, yesterday or whatever, I heard some movie that I wanted to watch. And I was like, ah, or maybe earlier today. And I was like, no. I can't be turning my brain to moosh.
Yeah. Oh, shoot. What was I going to say? Curfew party.
Mm-hmm. Scream 1.
Mm-hmm.
Randy's house.
I forget. Never mind.
Matthew Lillard. Skeet. All skeet skeet.
Mm-mm.
Oh, skeet, 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 skeet. I'm the killer.
Spoilers.
For Scream 1. Rebecca has a new house. It's Randy's house. Isn't that weird?
So weird.
Elena says Klaus is the only person who likes her, but says her boyfriend liked her more than once. What? Elena says Klaus.
I'm not sure what you wrote, but when...
Oh, Stefan liked Rebecca. Elena says Klaus is the only person who likes Rebecca, but then Rebecca's like, your boyfriend liked me more than once.
Right, because...
Like he was hitting it.
Yeah, exactly.
Back in the day.
And Elena's just going in hard on Rebecca because Elena's emotions are heightened.
Uh-huh.
But also, Rebecca's being a bee.
Yeah.
Making fun of dead Alaric. Oh, sorry, yeah. I killed him.
Where's Mr. Saltzman? I killed him. And then Elena tries to stab Rebecca, but then Rebecca stabs her instead.
In, like, her chest, kind of like in her shoulder, which is so ridiculous because they're just in their classroom. Mm-hmm. Like, you would definitely see if someone, first of all, tried to stab someone with a pencil, and then someone actually stabbed them with a pencil, and then they got up and they left bleeding. Like,
yeah,
someone would see that.
They would.
And then she's just in the bathroom, she just pulls it out, and then, like, I feel like someone would see that too. Anyways. Sometimes they are so loud doing vampire things in front of everyone else, and no one else ever knows.
No.
I'm like, how are you guys not...
But then they could always cajole them also, though.
I mean, that's true.
So I guess they don't really care. Yeah, they'll just neuralize all of them.
I would try to at least be like, let's be chill about it.
I bet Will Smith wishes he had a real-life neuralizer.
Oh, man. I bet you somebody made that joke, but I didn't hear it.
So long. Probably immediately 1,000 people tweeted that immediately when it happened. All right. Rebecca. Elena hates Rebecca, and she's raging. Then they see the hunter. Connor Jordan's just walking around the school. And, like, they're like, is he here to see Jeremy? Which, why did they think that?
Because he was standing in the hallway talking to Jeremy.
Oh.
But she was raging. So there's a dual meaning of rager.
Oh, the rager, yeah.
Title. Because Elena was raging out, and then the rager and then they party. Go
to a friggin' keg party.
Yeah.
I do really wonder how many 30 packs they had at that party.
Oh my gosh, I had 30 packs at my college graduation party.
Yeah.
That my parents got. It was great.
That's awesome.
And they filled the whole trunk of the car.
A truck. A truck bed.
Yeah, a truck bed with it.
That's awesome.
And with ice, and they made the whole bed of the truck a cooler. That was such a cool thing that they did.
My only complaint is that they made you drink all of them.
I was gonna say I don't remember drinking any of it, but maybe that's
you probably had like one.
Yeah, and I can't imagine.
What is that, 900 beers?
Yeah.
That's a lot of beers.
I know.
Were people crushing them?
I don't know. I just remember being like, that's so cool.
Yeah, that is cool. We should do that again now.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'd have 890 left.
I know.
Ash, Elena goes into the bathroom to clean up her stab wound.
Mm-hmm.
Heather comes in to the bathroom, and she's not okay. She says she has a big bite wound. And then Elena wants the blood, and then Rebecca rubs blood on Elena's face, and Elena's like...
Yeah, and Elena gets really H for B. But this was so gross when Rebecca did this, because she really just smeared blood, like, all over her face, and she was so messy. And Elena keeps being stuck in bathrooms at different places, like, covered in blood and trying to wipe it up with, like, toilet paper.
Oh, my gosh.
Like... She needs to start bringing some Clorox wipes in her backpack or something.
She does. Some wet ones.
I know, because she is getting real messy.
Didn't Caroline pull her aside and be like, Now, Elena, now that we're vampires, you need some wet ones.
Yeah, you're going to have blood all over yourself.
All the time. Connor Jordan has Jeremy in a classroom because Jeremy saw his tattoos.
Mm-hmm.
This is a hunter's mark.
Mm-hmm.
Jeremy is not convincingly denying that vampires exist in this scene.
Yeah, he's like, just denying that vampires exist are just going to make you look stupid.
Yeah, plain dumb makes you look dumb. Mm-hmm. Stefan is watching all of it. The tattoo is invisible, except to hunters and potential hunters.
Mm-hmm.
Ask your friend with a bandage on his neck, Matt. It's only visible to hunters and potential hunters. I think that's kind of BS. I bet it's also visible to... Oh, wait. I was going to say people who have died or whatever, but that was Matt who died. So yeah. I would think Matt would be able to see it, but he cannot.
No, and Jeremy hasn't died, but he can talk to Jost.
To Colin Jost, yeah. And Michael Chase.
He's a Jost too, just because he's friends with him.
Michael Che?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Damon is at Connor Jordan's RV, and he gets shot with arrows attached to mines.
I know.
That's good stuff. That's good Kevin Williamson stuff.
And then once Damon figured it out, he was like, oh. Like, he was just like, well, can't do anything now. I'm stuck.
What if he was shot with arrows that were attached to mimes, and they put him in a box, and he's like, no, I can't get out. And they were just like...
<That'd be> silly.
And then some winds blew them away. And he was okay.
Like, phew.
Whew. That was a close one.
Mm-hmm.
Caroline and Stefan and Elena are at high school. Elena's mad at Rebecca. And they're like, let's skip the rest of the day and have some fun. And they say, let's go to Rebecca's party to show her that she can't intimidate me, Elena mm-hmm. says.
Yeah. I appreciate the second piece of that, but Elena's whole thing was like, I'm going to school, so I can join senior year.
Mm-hmm.
And then she just leaves in the middle of the day.
Yeah.
I mean, she's doing senior high school type things, I guess, but she's peacing out.
Stefan, Elena's channeling all her emotions into rage.
The Rager.
Stefan used to do that when he was a Ripper.
It's funny how he references himself as the Ripper.
He was a Ripper, yeah.
Yeah.
Caroline says Stefan should write a book and go on The View about how to save vampires.
Because he did a good job of, like, mentoring Caroline.
Mm-hmm. I think that would blow his cover. Hayley comes in and calls Ty Lock Wolf.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Lock Wolf.
Oh, Wolf or Woof?
I think, Wolf. I mean, Woof.
Woof.
That's what I'm trying to say.
Oh.
Lock Wolf.
Lock Wolf. She is from Florida and helped him break his sire bond, apparently. And she wants fancy rich people scotch. Because she knows he's rich.
Yeah, she's like, oh, okay, look at this house. Give me the fancy stuff.
And I misspelled this, but this makes more sense. The song they were playing,
mm-hmm.
I was like, they got a Momford and Son song or something, which that makes more sense. Momford and Son. They were hitting the Frey.
Yeah, they had
some. Now they got the Momfords.
They had some standout hits. Songs.
Sometimes I buy a suit from Momford. Tom Ford. Damon calls Fel to help him get out of the bomb trap.
Mm-hmm.
Pastor Young was a patient of Dr. Fel. Did you know that?
Mm-hmm.
Damon ignores a call from Elena. You are a good brother, Fel says, because he's playing vampire while Stefan is with Elena.
Right. Well, yeah, she gets annoyed that she gets called in to help him.
Mm-hmm.
But Damon makes sense of why he needs her. But she's like, man, you're doing all this vampire stuff, getting shot by arrows, and Stefan's just with your girl, basically.
Yeah. He's Mr. Steel, your girl.
But actually, it's Stefan's girl, but, you know. Not in Damon's mind.
No. Rebecca invites Matt to her party. She ran him off the bridge, but she never wanted to hurt him, she says.
Yeah, I remember because Rebecca and Matt were, like, having, like, a little thing going on before Alark got killed.
Matt walks away. Then Connor grabs his arm and rips off his bandage and sees the two bite marks and asks, which one of your high school friends is a bloodsucker?
I mean, this is another thing they could have avoided. Elena could have drank blood from Matt, like, in some place where you couldn't just see a big bandage.
Butt cheek.
Yeah, butt cheek. I don't know, thigh.
Yeah.
Bicep.
Well, do you have to hit a vein or something?
I mean, that seems like it's right. They're getting their blood, but there's veins all over.
Yeah. It would be... Depending on, I mean, the neck and the arm is a little easier access. It would be like they go to the makeout spot, and she's like, all right, I'm going to drink from your, like, thigh vein. That would be,
that'd be really
risque.
Very risque. But at least Connor Jordan wouldn't be able to see it.
Exactly. Well, how did
he know? What Matt should say. Hey, Elena, you know what?
Yeah. Oh.
Connor Jordan keeps finding my band-aids. Yeah. Can you try sucking me over here?
Yeah, I don't want Connor Jordan to find my band-aids.
I knew I was going to land into something funny eventually with that, but it took me a minute.
Elena, look. Yeah.
Can't have my band-aids showing.
No. Now my pants are chafing me. He says that Rebecca Michelson is the bloodsucker.
Because everyone's mad at her.
And Connor's like, when you wake up, she'll be long gone. Then knocks out this kid. Connor Jordan doesn't play. I get that he just, like, shoots vampires all the time. But he just punches this kid.
This, like, 19 or 18-year-old.
All right. Elena needs Brothers Bond to get through Rebecca's party, she says. Oh, that's why she's up in her previous mansion and, like, going through Damon's stuff.
Yeah.
And Damon sends her to his underwear drawer.
She probably does win the Brothers Bond, but that was a lie, because she was looking through her stuff to find the White Oak.
The White Oak Ash.
Yeah.
Yeah. Damon is getting nude and asks if Elena is staying for the show. And then he goes like this. Wop, 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 wop. But she whooshes away. Jeremy goes to Connor Jordan, sells out Meredith Fell, which I think, looking back now, he's doing a plot.
Yeah.
But in the moment, I'm like, Jeremy.
You're like, don't tell.
Jeremy, are you doing a plot? Then Connor says they're going to the hospital, not the party. And then now there's a party scene. keg stands and True Religion jeans, I saw.
Oh my gosh.
Was there Von Dutch? I don't know.
Probably. That definitely is the era.
Stefan and Elena didn't need to be invited into the party.
Yeah, they were like, nice.
Stefan compels a drink out of a normie's hand.
Yeah, it's like, ew, Stefan. Now you're going to get all their germs.
What? He doesn't care about that. April is there.
He's a super healer. He can just drink everyone's germs.
April's there? That's interesting. April Young?
April Young.
Caroline ditched Rebecca's ditching party and sees Ty. He's on house arrest with the hybrids from Klaus.
With his twins.
Klaus, they're having a triplet party. Klaus greets Hayley, says Ty never mentioned her. Klaus is scheming to get Ty in trouble with these ladies.
Yeah, because Klaus likes Caroline.
And he's got a new horse drawing for her that he can't wait to give her. Elena goes up to April and gives her a beer, even though she used to read her bedtime stories.
Yeah, isn't that, like, so weird?
Yeah, and you know what? She, back when April was young, Elena would read her Horror from the High Dive Volume 1, but then they read Horror from the High Dive Volume 2 in this episode. Mm-hmm. Isn't that cool?
Totally cool.
If her dad could see her now, April says, she's in her denial phase dreaming up conspiracy theories. Uh-oh.
The conspiracy theory stage of grief?
Yep. Dab. Kada. What? She doesn't think it was an accident.
Mm-hmm.
Which proves conspiracy theories are right. We're one of those podcasts now.
No!
Rebecca walks up. It's like the town is cursed.
Mm-hmm.
Elena tells April to go look around your house. Around the house.
Yeah. Why don't you go look around the house?
And I'll find you. And I was like, what?
Yeah, that was a really weird thing to say. Yeah, not
go,
like,
go look around the house.
Hey, can you leave us alone so we can talk? Like, that would be a normal thing to say.
Yeah.
Just go look around the house and I'll find you. Like, what?
Let's play weird hide and go seek.
You're it.
Or I'm it, or who knows? Elena asks Rebecca if she blew up the house to get revenge on the council, but Rebecca doesn't care about the council.
Mm-hmm.
Rebecca stole Elena's daylight ring and throws it in the garbage disposal.
Yeah, and Elena's just stuck in the kitchen at this party in Rebecca's house.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. It's scary.
Yeah, and she gets burned by those lights, by the sunlight.
By the sunlight, yeah.
Mm-hmm. But that was probably a commercial break or something because then she just grabs the ring out of the garbage disposal.
Yeah, just suffers for a second.
That's how you got to play these act out sometimes. Like,
yeah. Like, what's she going to do? Oh, wait, she just solved it immediately.
Yeah. She's super mad, though. She has the stake. Stefan tries to stop her from killing Rebecca. And he's like, I'm not going to stop you, though.
He's trying to give her a moment of thinking time.
Yeah, it will feel good for 10 seconds, then vampires all over the world will die. All the vampires she turned, and he guilt trips her. But guilt will destroy her. So he's kind of weird. You can go after her or ride a motorcycle.
Yeah, those are your two choices.
On the way out, Elena rips an awesome keg stand.
Yes, she kicks herself up to a perfect keg stand. No one even has to hold her legs.
Mm-hmm. And Rebecca's vision starts to go blurry.
Mm-hmm. Did you know why at that point? Did you have any mid-ep Pete-dictions?
No, and I forget again now.
Yeah.
Klaus tells Ty that Hayley is fetching. She took the back door, so Caroline didn't see her. Then he guesses Ty had a thing with her when he was breaking his sire bond.
Mm-hmm.
Caroline has no idea about Hayley. Could be drama. Unless Hayley was a one-episode quitter.
Yeah, well, Klaus is trying to make it into a thing.
Yeah. There's always a Hayley in these shows, Ash.
There is, yeah.
Damon calls Ty, but Klaus picks up. Damon is going after the vampire hunter. Ty can't go, but Klaus wants to go.
Mm-hmm. Klaus, because Ty's on house arrest.
Mm-hmm. Stefan and Elena are on his hog. The shot looks a little suspect.
Yeah.
Some green screenery.
For sure.
Elena stands up on the back of the motorcycle and it looks like an Adam Sandler movie. And it looks like she's wearing a Banana Republic cardigan, not the most badass motorcycle outfit.
Yeah, right.
Fel is at the hospital. Connor and Jeremy are there. Damon is there. I like this part. Connor remembers that Damon was like, I'm a germaphobe. He didn't want to shake his hand with the vervain-soaked glove.
Right? But Damon's just like, I'm a vampire.
Yeah, did I say germaphobe? I mean vampire, and Connor gets shot by arrows.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I said they're doing too much with music in this episode.
Yeah, it was like a little distracting.
Elena and Stefan are making out. Elena is imagining Damon, and then she's like, no, and pushes Stefan off, and then her veins are wiggly.
That's what you wrote, her veins are wiggly?
And the hunter had werewolf venom.
Yeah, and where did he put it?
Probably in the keg or something.
Yeah, it was in the beer.
No.
And that's what happened to Rebecca, too.
Oh.
And that's why he was like, by the end of this night, they'll all be dead or whatever. Remember he said that?
Something like that.
And we were like, what? Why? How?
Matt checks on Rebecca. She doesn't feel good either. He wants to tell her how he feels. He thinks she's amazing. She had 1,000 years... He's probably saying that in a bad way. She had 1,000 years to learn, and she threw it all away, and now she's alone, and her brother hates her.
No, because he kind of was becoming friends with her, so I think he does like her in a sense, but then she's just, like, so evil that he's like, you could be cool and good, but you are sucking.
Yeah. The reason she doesn't find love is because she doesn't deserve it. Oh, she rips out his heart, but it's not real.
Yeah. Because she's, like, hallucinating.
Mm-hmm. Damon wants info from Connor.
Klaus, instead of just killing him.
Klaus is evil. He's interested in the disappearing tattoos. Oh, and he's like, he's one of the five.
Yeah, so Klaus recognized the mark on the stake.
Yeah. He pulls the bomb fuse and it explodes.
In the hospital.
Stefan is calling Klaus. Elena is wiggly, veiny, and imagining Damon. Stefan left too many voicemails on Klaus's phone asking Klaus to heal Elena. Klaus is mad. He's like, what if they had killed me?
Yeah, if you had killed me, then everyone right now that drank the beer would be dead.
Yeah, you need my blood.
All the vamps.
Klaus wouldn't have cared about Elena dying a few hours ago, but now she may be of use to him, and so he lets her feed on him.
Mm-hmm. Because he can heal a werewolf bite.
Yeah. And his care for Elena is wildly toggling. Like, it was so important to him mere days ago, or who knows, weeks ago. And then a few hours ago, it wasn't important. But now it's important again.
Yeah. Hey, by the way, I think she does say lock wolf. Like werewolf, lock wolf. Not lock woof.
I think it's like lock wood, but lock woof. Because she's like making a joke.
We have to listen back.
Yeah, we probably won't. Hit us up in the comments. Like and subscribe. Rebecca is having a hangover. April comes in. Everyone left. The cops came. April says she likes picking up trash. Rebecca offers to help look into the fire at the farmhouse.
I feel like this is weird that April is just still at this party picking up trash.
Mm-hmm.
That's really weird.
It is weird. Well, she's like a grieving orphan, whatever she says.
Yeah, she like doesn't know what to do or where to be.
Mm-hmm.
And then also it's interesting that Rebecca had the werewolf beer, but she doesn't die because she can only be killed by the white oak ash.
Mm.
She just gets really sick and hangovery.
Yeah, been there. Damon tells Mayor Lockwood that the sniper was killed in the explosion.
Mm-hmm.
Jeremy was the bait. Damon tricked Fel into blowing up the hospital.
And now she's mad.
She's mad. Damon was kind of joker-fied in this episode. Right?
Yeah.
Fel is not Damon's new partner in vampire crime. She is no Harley Quinn.
Yeah.
To his jokerification. Fel tells Damon to fix things with Stefan and Elena.
Mm-hmm.
Caroline says, hey to Stefan, do you remember what you were like before you turned? He asked her. She was an insecure control freak, which I remember they really put that on her.
They said that so many times.
Yeah.
She wasn't really that bad.
She grew into herself. And you know what? what people say about you, you become. So if they were just like, oh, you're cool, mm-hmm. she would have been a lot cooler.
I agree.
She grew into herself after she turned, is their narrative, though.
Mm-hmm.
Stefan wants Elena to grow into herself as well, which also, he's like a possessive weirdo.
But Caroline's being nice, and she's like, you helped me so much, and I couldn't do this without you, and blah, blah, blah.
If he wants to enjoy, oh, okay, Elena to grow into herself and I guess be like a badass or whatever, and he can't exactly do that, or he will become a ripper if he's, like, vamping out.
Isn't that seem kind of like a stretch, though?
Yeah, it's
like,
weird.
Oh, if Elena can be, like, a true vampire, it's going to make me kill everyone?
Yeah, he loves Elena and doesn't want to hold her back, but he doesn't know how to be around her and resist the urge.
Mm-hmm.
So he's kind of like, she should go, like, suck blood with Damon, I guess, but I can't do that.
But why? So what? So then she should do that. Does he have to be with her 24/7?
No.
Can't she just go drink some other people's blood on her own?
He and Damon are beefing about Elena. Caroline is good at being a vampire, he says. And, okay, come to Caroline whenever he wants, and she won't let him lose control. And I said, oh.
Yeah, now Caroline's going to be, like, his checks and balances.
Matt apologizes for something to Elena and offers his blood to her.
Mm-hmm.
Elena is having violent thoughts. It's driven by the hunger. She feeds. Oh, and he's like, are you sure you want to take that much? And she keeps sucking. Damon comes in and stops her. Damon compels Matt to forget.
Mm-hmm. Elena feels bad immediately.
Elena feels bad. Damon comforts her. You need to learn the right way to be a vampire. And I'm going to teach you.
I'll teach you to be a vampire. That's better. Sometimes we say the same things. Vampire life is good because it sounds like electric slide. Uh-huh. That's better than what I was saying. This is what Damon has wanted all along. For, like, the last 3 or 4 episodes or however. What is this, 4?
3. Season 4, episode
3. Yeah, he's like, I want to teach Elena how to be a vampire.
Yeah, I'm so good at it. With my soaps. Connor Jordan did not explode. Klaus has him. He's worth more alive to Klaus than dead. He's one of the 5. Connor doesn't know his own history. And it's made you the most well-protected vampire in town.
Vampire hunter.
Vampire hunter in town.
I'll teach ya why you are one of the 5.
That's good. One of the 5. I mean, gotta be 5 vampire hunters. Pete-diction time. One of the 5 vampire hunters.
Who are the other 4?
Connor Jordan is one of them. Timothy Steven.
I see a theme here.
Jimmy John.
Uh-huh.
Jared Fogel, weirdly enough. Jimmy John's. And the Jersey Mike.
What a crew.
Yep. So,
what's your rating?
I'm gonna go 1.87 fangs.
1.87? Okay, how come?
Because it's pretty good.
Yeah, I feel like it's just kind of like in the middle of stuff.
Yeah.
Like nothing's really like.
They're ramping up.
Yeah. I think I'm gonna do like a 1.5.
Okay, I'll give you that. All right, more Pete-dictions. All right, Connor Jordan, he's around. Him and Klaus, they hate each other, but they need each other.
Hmm.
Klaus is going to teach him the her story.
Okay, what about Hayley?
Hayley and Caroline. are going to beef. Mm. And Ty is going to get all mixed up in it. Caroline, I was breaking my sire bond, man.
Yeah.
You can't hold back when you're breaking your sire bond.
That's not how he sounds. What about Elena?
Elena is gonna go on some more motorcycle rides. Ooh, maybe she'll ride the motorcycle by herself, and that's how you know how cool she is and how independent she is. I don't need any of these brothers.
And then what about Jeremy?
Jeremy. I don't know. I don't know what he's up to.
I see invisible tattoos.
Yeah, he's going to go get some invisible ink. Get tatted up.
All right.
Probably, right?
I can't tell you.
Fel. She's going to be in the mix, probably.
Okay.
Pastor Young, zombie pastor.
No way. You really think that?
No. I don't know. That kind of makes me think that it's going to happen, though.
Sometimes your predictions are exactly right. Sometimes they're so, so wrong.
All right, but tell me zombie pastor wouldn't be tight.
I can't tell you.
Okay. Well, now I think that there will be a zombie pastor. All right. No games.
Okay.
The thing that I brought was just being mad about that Brendan Gleeson sketch.
Yeah, but it was fun to watch.
Yeah.
We were like, this is what we've been saying.
I felt validated. I felt seen and heard.
100%.
Ash, what do you got to plug?
Nothing.
Nothing? Ash, Horror from the High Dive, Volumes 1 and 2 are in online stores now.
Yeah, people need to keep getting the books.
Yeah, we're selling some books over here. I will have a signing event in the Central Maryland? Yes. Is that where we're at?
That's right.
I have a signing event in the Central Maryland area coming up. Mm-hmm. I may promote that here. Okay. Maybe not. Who knows?
All right.
But you should just buy the book anyway. Buy some Vampedi merch.
Oh, yeah.
tpublic.com. And then High Dive. Look for High Dive. Look for Vampedi. Ash is wearing a crew neck. Looks nice and cozy.
Yeah, it is.
I was wearing a tee yesterday. And at High Dive Publishing on Instagram.
And keep listening to the pod.
Yep.
Thanks.